Hello everybody, today we'll go through a Tanjore painting tutorial or a course. Since it's a solid course, it will consist of a series of videos. Please take time to sit back and watch all these videos so that you will be able to make a proper Tanjore painting. Okay, now in this video I'll give you a list of the raw materials required for this painting. First of all, you need a Tanjore board. This is a specially prepared board. Okay, it consists of a plywood board over which a cloth called a Gada cloth is stuck using gum prepared from maida paste. It is let dry, and then this yellow coating that you see here, it is formed by mixing chalk powder, Arabic gum and water in a certain proportion. It is applied over the board a couple of times. Each time it is let dry, it is sandpapered, and then it is coated with this, and finally you get this Tanjore board. Nowadays you don't have to go through all this pain. Tanjore boards, ready-made Tanjore boards, are available in specific art and craft shops or exclusive Tanjore painting shops, or you can even order for it online, so you don't have to go through all this process. So you need a Tanjore board to begin with, and the design which you are going to transfer to the board, and a carbon sheet, preferably a yellow carbon, to transfer the design from the sheet to the board, and then a paper tape to stick the carbon and the design onto the board, and a pencil to do the tracing. Okay, this is step one. Step two will be, after tracing the design onto the board, you will be giving an outline with a thin brush using the yellow ochre poster color. Okay, so thin outline so that the carbon line, the carbon print line, doesn't erase off as you keep handling the board, because painting will be the last process in the series. So by the time the eyes and ears, nose, all that might get erased off by the rough handling of the board, by the handling of the board. Okay, so yellow ochre and a thin brush. Okay, this is step two. Step three will be sticking the stones for the jewelry. See, you see jewelry all around the painting, so you have to stick stones for that. So it comes in various sizes and colors, predominant colors being green, red, white, and this is a pearl set. You can, when it comes to jewelry, it's open to you. You can go to any art and craft shop, you can explore on your own, whichever stone will suit the jewelry, you can always go and buy. There is no hard and fast rule. But the traditional ones that are used are called the Jaipur gems, which I'm showing here. Okay. It comes in various shapes like square, round. You have oval also. I don't have it here now. Even oval stones are available. Okay. And you're going to stick the stones onto the board using ferricol. Okay. This is step three. So the steps which I'm mentioning here will be a separate video. Each step will be covered as a separate video. After finishing the stone work, you will be doing the muck work. Okay, muck is a special preparation made from chalk powder, Arabic gum and water in a specific ratio. The same mixture used to coat the Tanjore painting board. Okay, I have prepared it, and usually it is filled inside a cone liner. For convenience, I have filled it inside a 3D liner box bottle. Okay, so this, using this you will do the muck work. Muck work meaning, see, when you look at this mandapam or pillar, say for example, you can feel there are lot of designs. Okay, ups and downs, projections in the pillar. So these designs and the highlights around the jewelry, all that is made using the muck prepared here. This is step 4. Okay. Step 5 will be sticking the gold foil over the muck work. See, there is gold foil all over the painting, all over the muck work if you look at it carefully. You will understand all this better when you're actually looking at the Tanjore painting video. Okay. So, this foil, it comes as a booklet like this. It's a piece of 25 sheets. You can buy the entire book or you can buy individual sheets. Okay, and then you will need two scissors. Okay, see, these are normal plain scissors and these are curved scissors. These are called nail scissors. If you can see, there will be a curve at the bottom. This is generally called in shops as scissors used to trim your moustache. Okay, you can ask for it like that. And then you need Arabic gum. Okay, Arabic gum are available as crystals in Tanjore painting shops. You have to buy them, soak them in water overnight, and then it becomes a gum. You don't use any other synthetic gum, you have to use Arabic gum. See, I have already melted it like this overnight and store it in airtight boxes and preferably put it in the fridge. Okay. So, and an empty box, a rough box used to store the cut gold foil pieces. Okay, this is step 5. So after sticking the gold foil, all you have to do is clean the stones. Okay, for that you have stone cleaning tools available in shops. Okay, this is for removing the round stones. And then you can use these tools like a toothpick, a cotton buds, a set of cotton buds. This is also used for cleaning the stones. Okay, because the residual muck or the fevicol that you use might get formed around the stones, and it's better you clean it so that it gives a neat finish. And you need a rough brush for using the Arabic gum and a rough cup for storing water. And finally, you need the set of poster colors. Okay, you have to choose the colors based on the painting to do the final finish. Okay, and at the end you will need what you call as Indian ink or watercolor ink. You preferably buy two colors, one is orange and the other is dark green. Using this will give a highlight on the golden areas finally at the end to give you that three-dimensional look and feel. Okay, it's called waterproof drawing ink from Camel. And finally, you need the gel pen or a rotary ink pen, using which you give the final outline. Okay, you give the highlights using the black outline.